Transportation in plants. At the end of this session, you will be able to know how the water and minerals are transported from the root to the various parts of the plant. Let us discuss about the function of xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem forms the vascular system. Xylem tissue transports the water and minerals from the root to the various parts of the plant by the process called transportation. Translocation, it is a process of transporting the food substances from the leaves to the various parts of the plant through phloem. Generally, the cellular transportation processes are classified into two types. One is passive transport, another one is active transport. In passive transport, the substances are moved from the higher concentration to the lower concentration without the utilization of energy. Is of two types, one is simple diffusion, another one is osmosis. Coming to the active transport, here the substances are moved from the low concentration to the higher concentration with the utilization of energy. Here we'll see passive transport and active transport. Here high concentration and here low concentration. The substances move from high to low without the utilization of energy. This is called passive transport. Here low and here high. The substances move from low to high with the utilization of energy is called active transport, and it is facilitated by membrane bound proteins. These are the membrane bound proteins called pump, which facilitate the active transport. Next process is osmosis. Here, the substances move from the high concentration to the lower concentration through a selectively permeable membrane. It's called osmosis. Coming to the plasmolysis, this is a normal structure of plant cell. It has a cell wall, cell membrane, and a cytoplasm. If the water moves out from the cytoplasm, the cells start to shrinkage away from the cell wall. This process is known as plasmolysis, and the cell which undergone the plasmolysis is called plasmolyzed cell. Coming to the imbibition, it is a type of diffusion. The solid part of the plant absorbs the water and gets swelled up. Example, dry grapes and seed. If we soak the dry grapes in the water, it absorbs the water content and became swelled up. This process is known as imbibition. How water moves into the plant. Here the water enters into the root hair and then it is transported to the epidermal cell and then transported to the cells of cortex. Finally, it reaches the xylem. From the xylem, it is transported to the various parts of the plant. There are two types of movements of water will occur in plants. One is apoplast, another one is symplast. In apoplast pathway, the water moves through the intercellular space. It do not enter into the cell. But in the symplast, the water enters into the cytoplasm of the cell and then it is transported to the adjacent cells through the channel called plasmodesmata. Coming to the transpiration, it is a process of evaporation of water in the form of water vapor through stomata is called transpiration. This is the structure of stomata. It consists of two guard cells. When water enters into the guard cells, the stoma get open and the transpiration will occur. At the end of the transpiration, the guard cell became flaccid and the stoma get closed. Translocation of minerals. Minerals are remobilized from older leaves to younger leaves. Generally, phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen, and potassium are easily mobilized, but the element calcium cannot be remobilized. Phloem transportation. This is otherwise called a source and sink relationship. Leaf is a source of the plant where the food is prepared. Sucrose is a complex form of food. It is transported to the various parts of the plant through the phloem. Sink is a storage part where the food gets stored. It may be any other part of the plant. Ascent of sap. It means the transportation of water and minerals from the root to the leaves. that is the upward movement. The water enters into the root hair through the process osmosis, and then it is transported to the stem by the process of root pressure. Capillary actions result in raise up the water at the base of the stem. Adhesion and cohesion makes the column of water molecules. Adhesion means the force of attraction between the different molecules. Cohesion means the force of attraction between the same molecules. Finally, it reaches the leaves where the transpiration occurs. As a result, it creates a transpirational pool. Due to that pool only, the water gets transported from the root to the leaves. That's all about the ascent of sap. That is the movement of the water from the root to the leaves.